Hi and welcome to the initial basic tutorial of how to calculate the power of a number. Okay, I will not select any of the radio buttons. If I click on this, nothing happens. Okay, you can see that nothing happens. Okay, but if we select the power of a number and click on solution, there we go. As you can see, 2 to the power of 1 is 2, 2 to the power of 2 is 4, 2 to the power of 7 is 128, 2 to the power of 12 is 4090. That's how it goes. We can also carry out multiplication timetable and just enter whatever value you want in there and there. Okay, as you can see, I have a text box and a label here that says enter a number, and if we click on clear, what you notice is everything is cleared. Supposing we click on the power of 10, we can also clear it. Okay, if we do this with maybe multiplication timetable, the same thing applies and it can be cleared as well. We also have an exit button. If you click on no, the system stay put, and if you click on exit, the system exit. Now we are in Visual Basic, so what I will do now is to show you guys how I've put this together. That's the form size. You can design your form to whatever size you want, and here is a radio button. There's another radio button there. The radio buttons each has their own name. The name of this is timetable, while the other radio button is called RB power, and they have a label. Also have a text box. Now the label and the text box, when you double click on the form, there, as you can see, visibility of the label and the text box is false. Whatever content is in there in the text box is cleared. Whatever content we have inside the list box is also cleared. Now let's go back to the form. If we double click on solution, there, right here, we have the following variables declared: number, counter, and label is cleared. Why? Number is assigned two values. Okay, it's assigned two. Now if you click on the power, which is this radio button there, what will happen is this calculation will take place, which means 4 counter equals 1 to 12. That means counter will just generate 1 to 12. Okay, and whatever is generated by counter is listed inside the list box. Why number equals 2? And what will happen is, because there's a loop there, the first time it goes around the loop, number is 2, and the second time becomes 2 multiplied by number, and now give you 4. And the next time it goes around the loop, 2 multiply by 4, that'll give you 8, and so on up to 12. Okay, that is it there. Supposing we select the radio button for timetable, this is what happened, that generates 1 to 12 and the multiplication timetable is carried out right there. Okay, now let's come back down here. If we double click on clear, those are the lines of code to clear the button. Now if we double click on exit, those are the lines of codes that exit the system. And finally, if we double click on the text box and go to key press right here, those are the lines of code for key press. The whole reason for these lines of code is to prevent the end user from entering alphabets characters. So let me show you guys the codes again. Let's take it from the top. Okay, that's a form load. That is the button. Okay, this is to calculate the power of whatever number you enter from here down here, and from here down here that calculates the carries out the multiplication timetable. This line of code prevents the end user from entering alphabets into the text box, and here that is for exit. Why down here, when you select radio button timetable, all of this happens, text box becomes visible, number text box number become enable, which is TXC number enable, and focus is set. The label is visible. Whatever data is in there is cleared. List box is cleared as well. And if you select the power radio button, text box becomes enable, becomes false. Label visible become false. TXC number visible becomes false. And we also cleared the data in there. Why the data inside the list box is also cleared. And that is the clear button itself. Once you click on the clear button, all of the data are cleared. And the text box, list box disappears. Why all of the radio button checked becomes false. So if I run it again, and there we go, guys. So you can click that and just select the solution to give you the power of these numbers. Okay, multiplication timetable, enter whatever value you want there. You can clear and you can exit if you want. Okay, with that, I'm going to leave you guys with this nice tutorial. I suppose you all enjoy it. You all have a nice day now. Bye for now.